Although the house felt empty, Stan found himself inserting memories of before into the space. He fantasized that Carmen had just popped into the office for a meeting and would be back on the 5 o'clock bus, the jangle of her silver bracelets announcing her arrival. Then, over a cup of tea, she would natter on about how many words her editor had slashed, or which new intern had the office all aflutter. Carmen had always had an aura of energy about her. It's what had so appealed to Stan, her vitality and enthusiasm. The way she spoke with her hands, laid her palms over her heart when talking about something emotional. The fire and shine in her eyes when she was angry. She was more Greek than any of his Greek relatives. But right now, Stan was relishing the quiet and space, his carefully chosen memories providing more than enough of Carmen's energy. Her stay in hospital afforded the family a chance to recover, and by the time she was discharged home, everyone felt refreshed, renewed, stronger. Carmen, too. And once more they all eased into a new normality. A couple of weeks later, as Stan was about to introduce a bunch of new students to the techniques of throwing clay, there was a power outage. Despite the studio having loads of natural light from its large picture windows, the class had to be canned because most of the pottery wheels were electric. Estimated time till restoration, 3 hours. It was not worth hanging around, so Stan headed home. He was driving up Beach Road when he spotted her, half walking, half running, in lime green trainers and black leggings, her auburn ponytail popping out the back of her cap.